time for the cake yet, though.
No, it's not time for the cake, Kara.
We're making a summer salad, though, with bright colors and freshness, and that sounds delicious, too. We should always have a little nutrition before we eat our dessert.
There are actually ingredients grown right here in Connecticut, which is just awesome. Grace Vallow of TastefullyGrace.com is showing us how to make an arugula salad with grilled corn, blueberries, and sharp cheddar cheese. Hey, Grace, how are you?
Hi, how are you? So good to see you.
Very good to see you, too.
This is really interesting. You know, I love arugula. Like, I'll buy that at the store, just even if you're putting very little on it. Just seems like it's a little bit different.
It's like a little bitter.
But I wouldn't think the cheddar and the blueberries and the corn.
I cannot see anything because the reflection from your engagement ring is so shiny.
Oh, did you notice?
Did you get engaged?
So shiny?
I did.
Congratulations.
About a lucky fellow that has you cooking for him.
Eric is the lucky man.
Well, he is.
Yes, and he bought me something very sparkly too.
That is beautiful. I can't complain.
No, does he cook?
Awesome.
Yes. He doesn't cook.
Good.
I'm the cook.
That's what makes a marriage.
I think he's the lucky guy too.
He is the lucky guy for sure. Scott would have married you just for your cooking.
There you go. Can eat croissant croutons every day.
Oh my God. All right, so how do we begin? Where are we going?
All right, so we're going to start over here with some fresh blueberries from local farmers' stands, actually in Glastonbury. Look how beautiful they are.
Okay.
And we're going to pop them right into this big bowl of arugula.
Big bowl of arugula.
And you can buy that. It's so nice because you can get it at most grocery stores. It'll come already pre-washed, and it's a little bit more elegant than just regular lettuce, but it's
so
you don't have to chop it. You just pour it in the bowl.
So true. And I love the bitterness and also, you know, kind of the tartness of the blueberries. It's a really nice kind of combination.
Oops.
Here, I have tongs for you.
Tong?
There you go. That way you don't mess up your suit.
All right, looks
good.
There
you go.
You know, and we grill corn a lot on the grill, and then if people don't finish it, I never know what to do with it. So you should keep it
for a salad. So you can just take it right off the cob.
Mm-hmm.
And I grilled this for about 5 to 10 minutes or so. Blueberries falling everywhere.
Kiss it up to God, 5 second rule.
Oh my gosh.
Sorry.
You ate it. And take it right off the cob. This is about 6 to 8 ears of corn. So it's actually quite a bit to make about a cup and a half.
Okay.
So I'm gonna stick that right in there.
Uh-huh. Beautiful.
So the corn though does make a difference when it's grilled.
It does.
It has that charred taste. I don't know what is going on over here.
I keep
Scott, like, use the tongs.
Can you toss it away? He wants to really toss it.
Okay, is that walnuts?
Yes, walnuts. So these are chopped walnuts. I didn't do anything to them. It gives it a nice crunch, though, the salad.
Okay.
You could toast them if you wanted to be a little extra fancy.
Very heart healthy.
But yes, very heart healthy. About, again, a cup and a half. It's about even proportions throughout.
Okay.
And then we have some extra sharp cheddar cheese.
Extra sharp.
And I like extra sharp in this because it's salty. It has a real kind of strong, assertive taste, and it adds some nice sharpness to the salad. So you can go ahead and toss that.
Okay.
And then for the dressing, it's very simple. All I use is a lemon, so I'm gonna cut that in half. And you can give it a nice squeeze in this bowl here.
There's salt and pepper in there?
Salt and pepper already. Squeeze the lemon.
I always have to
go to the gym before so I can squeeze this lemon.
Mm-hmm.
And then I have some garlic too. So I'm just gonna mince some garlic, finely mince, and just one clove is good, one big clove. There you go. Put it right in there. Oh, look at this mixing.
Now,
it's quite impressive.
A lot of people cheat and have those jars of minced garlic at home. If you're making a fresh salad, is it necessary to use the
I think it makes all the difference.
Okay.
Because it really, I mean, a little bit goes a long way.
In the jar.
Yes, exactly. And
and you only need a little bit here. You use a clove or so?
Yep, a clove.
Now what are you adding?
Extra virgin olive oil. Use about a half of a cup or so.
Okay.
It depends on how strong you
lemon,
want.
Lemon, olive oil, salt, pepper, and garlic. That's it.
And it makes just such a nice, bright dressing. Nothing crazy.
One whole lemon, and then what did you say for how much olive oil?
About half a cup to maybe 3/4 of a cup. It really depends on how crazy lemony you like it.
Okay, so you can kind of decide
just
how to
give it a good toss.
Wow, that's
and
beautiful.
Then the finishing touch here.
The pièce de raison. What do they call that, Karen?
Croissant croutons.
Oh my gosh.
Aren't they beautiful?
Croissants are amazing, so why wouldn't you make them into a crouton?
I know. And it adds that butteriness to it,
too. So what do you do? You take croissants and then you just toast them?
Break them up and toast them. You could add a little olive oil if you wanted, but honestly, it's just kind of good on its own.
Oh my God.
That's what I think.
So if you're buying them,
you can just toss them in there.
These were already baked croissants that you then just put back in.
Right, exactly. You could make your own, but why put yourself through that, right?
Right. Okay.
You toss it all together.
And that's it. And they're already buttery. You didn't need to do anything to them.
Right. And they toast up nice and perfectly. About 350 for 5 minutes or so.
I'm not going to double dip. I'm just going to take it right out of the bowl.
There you go.
I've heard that the way to know, this is an unusual combination to me, but I've also heard that if things are in season at the same time, they go together. So the corn and the blueberries go together.
My yes. blueberry just ran away.
There's lots of things running away today. Blueberries and...
Mine.
So good.
So good, right?
So good. It doesn't even need like real chicken or anything. You could put that on there, but it's delicious on
right.
its own.
The delicious. Sweet so and the tart, buttery.
Right. Carol, I'm sorry, I'm eating.
All right. You're going to find this recipe and many more on Grace's website. It's tastefullygrace.com. This is a great salad to put in your rotation. Be sure to also connect with her on Instagram and Facebook. For cooking inspiration, you can use the handle tastefullygrace.